currently 10:51. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So like you can see, I have some major, you know, acne pigmentation spots going on my face right now. So the base routine which I've been normally doing for the past 3 to 4 months or maybe more, like to get a natural finish, is not working for me right now. It's been a while I did this routine because I was not having like major scars or any issues. I think for the past 6 to 7 months, last year around this time I had my skin like this, and that time I used to do this routine again. It's now 1 year later, I'm back to that stage. Like literally my scars were, anyways, that's not the topic. So let's get into the video and I'll show you how to do a simple, normal, kind of full coverage routine for the base if you have, like, you know, pigmented spots like me, or if you have acne prone skin or something like that. So yeah, let's get started. So if you have some major like pigmented spots or like pigmentation on your face, then you would definitely need a full coverage. Like basically you would need a niacinamide serum in your routine, but you know, for makeup you would need a full coverage concealer. So usually during my regular days, if you want to call that, I like my base to be quite natural. Like I have my full coverage moments, but usually I want to keep it natural, so I use a sheer coverage foundation and you know, just like get it over with. It's quite simple and easy. But now at this point, I cannot use a sheer coverage foundation because these scars kind of peep through it, and I don't like using a full coverage foundation always. And even sometimes this, like especially this spot right here, is peeping through even a full coverage foundation because it's that pigmented. So let's start off with skin prep. And if you have acne prone skin, skin prep is really important, especially because you know you're breaking out and you're, you know, you maybe used a drying cream somewhere, so you have flaky skin, you have sensitive skin, so you want everything to be really hydrated. So first I'm going in with this Requel moisturizer. It's an oil-free moisturizer, so it's kind of light on the skin. So I'm just going to lightly apply. Don't like apply too much also, just enough so that your skin is nice and moisturized and ready to go in for your makeup. Since you're going to use concealer, I'm just, you know, going to add an eye cream. So this is the Estee Lauder eye cream. You can just use the same moisturizer. You don't have to like be bougie and use eye cream. Now I have this, so I'm using it, or else I always use my moisturizer. So skin is nice and, like, you know, at least moisturized. Eyes are moisturized, face is moisturized. Keep in mind that I did do my skincare already before this. Like I think it's been 2 to 3 hours I did my skincare. So just to rejuice, I just added that. It's not my entire skincare routine. If you want to see that, then tap here. Now before again going in with the base, I'm just going in with the Smashbox primer water just to prep the skin a little more. So if you have this type of minimal scars or pigmented spots, then you know, like a BB cream on or sheer coverage, medium coverage would be fine. But you know, things like this, I don't know why I'm breaking out so much. It is so weird. Suddenly, like last month only, until then I didn't have anything, and now I don't know. I think my PCOS is having its moment. So first, since I have oily skin, I'll be using a little bit of powder. So for powder, I'm going in with the Maybelline Fit Me, and I'm in the shade medium. So I'm just taking that and I'm going to put it here. So it kind of gives me a little coverage also. So for concealer, like I said, you need a full coverage concealer. So for that, I'm going in with this Huda Beauty Overachiever concealer. It's like full coverage, and make sure the concealer shade is close to your skin as possible. Like it can be a little lighter or darker because of course we are going to go on with foundation on top of it, but make sure it's like almost close. This is a little lighter than my skin tone, but I can manage it, so I'm going ahead with this. I'm just applying this on the spots where I need that maximum coverage. I'm not going to apply this on the entire face. Only these major like, you know, acne spots which you can very evidently see and which will peep out through the foundation. Sometimes even if you use a full coverage foundation, these marks are seen, so you can do this even before you go with a full coverage foundation. I would usually prefer you to, you know, do this technique so that your, you know, base looks a lot flawless, or maybe like a little natural, not very heavy, very cakey. This would give you a more natural finish. You'll see the end look anyways. So yeah, that's about it. Maybe one right here. now I'm not gonna touch that for a minute. I'm going to let it dry and then I will blend it. I'm not gonna blend it before it gets dry so that I'll have more coverage. So I'll see you in a minute. Or maybe like after this edit. So we are going to take a dense brush, basically something which can blend your concealer well. And it's important for you to take a brush because sponge will remove the coverage again. So like, you know, take a brush for blending your concealer. So now I'm just going to blend the edges, not the on the spot, only the edges to diffuse it a little bit. So be very light-handed when you do that. You don't want to like, you know, remove the product off. So like you can see, I'm like being so gentle. So see the way I'm like doing it, very, very light taps, and I'm blending it out without moving the product a lot. Now, if you use the concealer which is full coverage but it doesn't dry down matte, so it might move around a little bit. This Huda Beauty concealer, once it dries down, it's like there, stays, doesn't move at all. It's like, you know, very, very matte. The only thing is it has fragrance. It's very mild though, but you know, if I have to cover something, then this is the concealer, full coverage. And even the Benefit one is, you know, really nice. This Benefit Cakeless concealer. But the thing is that shade is not suiting me, but I would definitely recommend that too. The shade is like a lot lighter to cover my concealer, scars, that is what I mean. That is it. Like, just, you know, add the concealer on the spots. You can see all that major spots which you could see earlier are completely gone. So now you can easily go in with a sheer medium coverage foundation or a BB cream or a CC cream, whichever you like, because rest of the face is not something which you need coverage on, right? So now I'm just going to use, you know, a sheer coverage foundation. So I can either go in with this or this. So this is a lot less coverage than this one, but I just want to mix these two together shades. They are like very sheer coverage, medium coverage foundations. So I'm just going to take one pump of this. This is the shade 3.2. And this is the L'Oreal Fresh Wear, is in the shade 260. So I'm just taking two pumps of it. Okay, now just properly just mixing the foundation, and I'm just going to dot it all over my face. Now whatever I do is kind of going to be like the normal ish of the process. I'm just taking the sponge and I'm going to lightly blend all that into the skin. I love these two foundations. I mean, such a beautiful finish. So lightweight and beautiful, beautiful formula. I really, really love these two foundations. So if I didn't conceal my pigmented like acne scars or marks, whatever, they would have been creeping through the foundation a lot now, and I would like, you know, need to add more foundation, and it would be like a huge disaster. So now bumps, of course, you cannot hide. I mean, there's no magical makeup product which would hide your bump or your acne. But you know, scars, like the pigmented spots, can be done. Now if you see something like this, which looks a little odd, you know, in person, I don't know if it's like seen that much on camera, in person it looks a little weird. So you can just slightly go over with the foundation and blend the edges so that it doesn't look as odd. And once you add the powder anyway, everything is going to look a lot blended. This is kind of looking a little odd because I added that drying cream and it's a little flaky on that part. But yeah, the rest of the face is really nice. Now let's just add concealer. So one thing is, if you want your makeup to look really natural, then you can always skip on concealer and just go in with that foundation under the eye. It kind of gives a very, very, very natural look. So now moving on to the powder, you can go with the full coverage, like basically coverage powder, like the Maybelline one, because it would add more coverage, or you can go with the translucent one, which would like just, you know, set your face. So I usually prefer a translucent one because it's a lot lighter and it look a lot natural. The Maybelline one is good enough. You can definitely use it, but it kind of looks a little heavy compared to a translucent powder. So I'm just going in with the translucent one and I'm just going to set it. Like, sometimes if you do need a lot of coverage, then you can just add that powder in that certain area. I'll just show you how to do so. So for under eyes, I'm just setting. One just drawback about the translucent is it does give a gray cast if you have a lot deeper skin. So I'm just taking this Maybelline powder, and let's say this is that area where I had that major scar, so I can add this powder there. So it'll give me a lot more coverage in that area because this powder does already add a lot more color. Next, we're moving to contour and blush, but you need to be very like careful while you do this because you use like a concealer, foundation, powder and everything to hide those marks and the pigmentation. You don't want to ruin it and lift it off. Now, so I am going to, you know, just take the contour or a bronzer on a fluffy brush and I'm just going to pat it, like tap it. Even when there's like the no need for doing that, that's the best way to apply your bronzer because it kind of blends it really well and doesn't move your foundation. So like you can see, I'm just tapping on the areas I need. I'm not stroking. Once you start stroking, the product is going to start lifting away. So be very mindful and just gently tap on your face. So just see how my hand is going. Just tap, guys. Like, you know, up, down, up, down. I'm a trainer now. Okay, that's it. I just applied, oh my god, I just washed my hair, bro. I need to remove this. Having things on your hand is never a good idea. I always apply, like get it onto my shirt or my hair. Yeah, I just blow dried my hair. Some disaster has to happen in every video. So anyway, I was like itna flow mein I was doing, so okay. Anyway, so just tap on it and don't move it. Now let's say I'm applying blush right here. I need to be very, very careful because this is right where my major spot is, like that very pigmented spot, which I did a lot of effort to try and, you know, cover. So next I'm going in with the Kylie blush, and again I'm going with the same brush and I'm just again coating it. Now be very careful, lightly just dab, no strokes, keep dabbing. If you want to see how I actually blush, contour, highlight, I'll put a video here, you can click on that and check. It's a long video where I explain it really well. See, the product didn't lift off, but we have a blush right there. Looks so pretty. Now, if you have acne or acne prone skin or textured skin, matte base is the best. Glowy base is so overrated, so overrated. I mean, I think people are going to come for me for saying that, but I think glowy base is very overrated. Like after a point, it'll just look like grease on your face. So, I mean, it's definitely good, but if you have really good skin, if you have textured skin, then it's really difficult for glowy makeup to look good because it kind of enhances your texture. And if you have oily skin, it'll become greasy, messy, and it's a whole different thing. So we can just use a highlighter when needed, right? So I'm just going to finish the rest of the makeup and I'll be right back. Bro, I wore my top inside out this entire video. Why do these things keep happening to me? My god, this entire video my top was inside out. I don't know if you noticed, but I realized it when I was applying my mistake. Like, oh shit, not lip mistake, lipstick. I lost it already. So yeah guys, this is the completed look. I'll just zoom you guys in. Before that, I'll just tell you the lipstick I'm wearing. This is the Spectra Cosmetics in A Listener 108. Hello, can you focus? Yes. So, such a beautiful shade, right? I love the shade. That is how the makeup looks zoomed in. So, it feels really lightweight and looks really flawless because we didn't like use a full coverage foundation and caked my skin up. We just, you know, spot concealed wherever necessary. And then we applied the sheer medium coverage foundation on the rest of the face. And you can see, like, I kept this matte. So, I applied my highlighter on top. I didn't apply on this bump because it's gonna exaggerate it. So yeah, this is how it looks. I would definitely recommend you to try this technique if you have some acne spots, and if you usually go in with full coverage just to cover that, try spot concealing and see, and let me know in the comments below if it worked for you. This is the completed look. I kept it pretty simple because I have to shoot fashion videos. If you're not following me on Instagram, then do follow, because I'm doing a 30-day series of OOTD, so check me out on Instagram. Hi guys, I didn't plan on doing this, but it's so late, so might as well do it. So it's currently 10:51, so it is almost 11 o'clock in the night, and I had this makeup on, like I put this makeup on at 2 o'clock, so you can see nothing budged, no scar is still peeping through, nothing is faded. I just changed the lipstick because I'm shooting outfits. So yeah, that's a check-in. That is what, 9 hour check-in. Now I'm exhausted, I'll go now. But yeah guys, that's it. I hope this video was useful, and if you like the video, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.